Welcome to PC Mag's One Cool Thing. I'm John Burek. This is Matt Buzzy. We are here today with a PC that, in its marketing materials at least, claims to be unique. Mm-hmm. How is this PC unique, Matt?
This is the world's smallest liquid-cooled mini PC, according to the manufacturer, Geekom.
Mm. And we haven't actually seen anything else to disprove that there's anything smaller than that.
It looks small to my eye, certainly.
It is that, yes. So, interestingly, we spent a bit of time looking at this machine. Mm-hmm. It's right now a Kickstarter-only device, but it should be coming out of Kickstarter on the 1st of November.
Yeah, way overshot its backing, its funding goal. So it is being produced. They're telling us, as of recording this video, it's ready to ship November 1st. So you can start ordering it then.
All right. So what we're taking a look at here is the general body of it. But there's a couple of cool design things going on here with this machine. Mm-hmm. You'll notice pretty clear from the front. You can see the liquid tubes going around in these four hoops in the front. Those are cooling both the CPU and the GPU.
Yep.
And we were talking about this PC a little bit before we shot this video, mm-hmm. and we were trying to figure, like, what are the actual parts in here? Are they laptop parts? Are they desktop parts?
Mm-hmm.
And pretty unequivocally, I mean, the CPU is clearly a laptop part.
Yep.
The GPU wasn't entirely clear from the manufacturer's page, but in one spot, it does say it's a laptop part, and there's nowhere here really you could have it.
You would see a graphics card in this setup. Yeah, I think it was a little more upfront that it was a mobile processors. That was pretty, but the RTX 4060, which is inside every model of this mini PC, was just being referred to as an RTX 4060. And I was looking in the materials, and I saw laptop GPU listed. So makes a lot of sense with what we are seeing with our eyes.
Right. So actually, we didn't mention what it's called.
Yeah.
It's actually called the Megamini G1, mm-hmm. from a company called Geekom. Geekom makes a whole line of mini PCs. Most of them are not nearly so flashy as this.
Yeah, not really high-end gaming things for the most part. It's digital signage, PCs, little office productivity machines, things like that. And it's in partnership with a company called Tecno. That's a Chinese mobile manufacturer. So two of them came together and produced this.
Right. So what do we have here? So we have a... We have several SKUs.
Yes.
Right. So in the initial SKU the base SKU, mm-hmm. that Geekom is going to be offering, we're looking at I believe a Core i7.
13th gen H-series,
right.
Yep.
Right. And this is a Core i9, the one we have here, H-series as mm-hmm. well. Both of the H-series are obviously laptop chips.
Yeah.
And the GPU is 4060 across the line.
Yes, despite, it has the liquid cooling, powerful parts, and there's some variation in the chips, but even... from the entry model up to the highest configuration in terms of memory, storage, and processor, the 4060 remains a constant across the board.
Yep. Yeah, actually, if you take a look at this, we're going to turn the machine a little bit towards the camera, mm-hmm. there. One of the unique aspects of this is the radiator,
yeah.
that's cooling the CPU and the GPU. So we got the liquid pipes here, which are pumping, to the motherboard, which is parallel to the desk here, mm-hmm. or to the table here. The radiator for both of those components is in the back, but it also sort of loops around underneath the cooling fan in a L shape. So it gives a little more surface area for the radiator to exist in this really small form factor. So you've got the fan sort of nested inside the body of the L.
Yeah, the attractive and, rather unique cooling tubes are kind of the eye, the draw to your eye. They look... the coolest, and obviously they help your computer keep running cool, but the radiator L shape is actually what enables, at least from reading on the design, enables it to be in such a small volume. The radiator is actually the unique sort of thing that enables the entire design to work as it does.
Yep. Yeah, the secret sauce behind this machine.
Mm-hmm. And so there's two fans. One is at the top. You can probably hear it even just idling. It's not even, connected or driving anything right now. It's just powered. Mm. It's pretty audible. Mm. It's not that surprising, right? In a small form factor, you get this sort of noise from a laptop, but more so when it's under load, less so when it's just idling. So, it is a little loud. You can probably pick that up on the mic, but it's not terrible. It's definitely audible.
Yep. But yeah, that said, this is the kind of thing where if it's on your desk next to you all day and you're going to ramp up renders or gaming, I could see wanting to have a headset on.
Yeah.
Because it's not in order.
When we turned it off before, it was like,
Right.
It was a bit of a relief. And that's without running anything demanding. So, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So we do have a carry handle here on the top, or at least a gripping handle. It's a little shallow, but you can rotate the machine that mm-hmm. way. And one of the other interesting aspects of this machine is, given its size, awful lot of ports on it.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. So we can go around the sides and take a look at what's there.
There's quite a few. On the front is it's all USB and the headphone jack. So
yeah, there's like four USB-A's on the front, which is, I mean, for cleanliness sake, you will probably want to plug your peripherals into the back. But for USB drives and if you're swapping in and out different storage devices, you got a ton of USB-A up front.
Yep.
Combo headset jack on the my right, camera left, there's a surprisingly an SD card slot.
It makes sense for sort of people who might use this more powerful system, especially with the i9, to be moving a lot of media back and forth off one device and onto this machine. So that's always nice to have.
For content creators, it does make sense. Just surprising to see a full-size SD card on desktop, which is not as common these days as it used to be. We've got this nice ventilation scheme on the back of the machine here. And then if we look at the panel with all the ports toward the bottom here, it's a little bit underneath this overhang, so it might be hard to see. We've got a whole lot going on. There's two HDMI outputs for video. We've got two USB-Cs with DisplayPort connectivity for video output if you choose to use it for that. Two more USB-As. And then also there's an Ethernet, a dedicated Ethernet jack and a Oculink port, which
External GPU. Should you want to take, another 40, more powerful 40 series GPU and ramp up the power.
Right. Yeah, we actually haven't seen that, I don't believe, on a desktop to date.
No, it's usually discrete systems with that or a laptop. One interesting thing that we didn't touch on, too, is this little screen at the top, which gives readouts of, the different component performance temps and those sorts of things, which is just kind of nice to have,
gives a little bit of flair.
Yeah, sometimes those are, if you do like a DIY system build, you can put those on. Sometimes the liquid cooler will have that on the front, or some graphics cards have a little screen with that readout. So, built into the system because why not?
Right. Yeah. So, in terms of availability, as we were saying, Kickstarter now available in retail November 1st. Talk a little bit about the SKUs and the pricing.
Yeah. The lower models start. The i7 models is lowest, and as I said, the 4060 comes with everything, and then you can get 32 gigs of memory and a terabyte of storage. I think it's around $14.99.
Yep.
There's different sale prices right now available on the Kickstarter for backing it early versus what the actual retail prices will be. So, the MSRP I think is slightly higher than those like specials that are available at the time we're looking at this, but in that ballpark, and then the higher Core i9 model is more towards $17.99, $18.99.
Yep, that's correct. Yeah. So, I think our SKU is Core i9, 2 terabytes, and 32 gigs of memory with the 4060.
Yep.
All right. So in the time that we've been standing here, the system is actually ramped down in sound, right?
Yeah, I just noticed it actually kicked much lower. Right. the three previous times that I've plugged it in and sort of messed with it, even right here where we had it not under load, it's not connected to a monitor, it's not running anything. Fans were pretty loud, as you heard and as we were saying before, but now it's almost completely quiet, and I do see it's still on and active. So hopefully this is a little bit more indicative of the idling state, and this is what you can expect unless you start playing a game or start doing some content creation, then we would expect it to be much louder. But if this is idle, then we're not going to complain about the noise because there barely is any.
Right. So once we get a final retail model of this test, this is still a pre-release, we'll be benchmarking it and we'll be seeing what sort of noise we get out of it, and we'll definitely report on that. But for the moment, it seems to have
much
chilled out.
Yeah.
Couple of other specs that we didn't talk about. Storage, the upticked model that we're looking at here is 2 terabytes of storage, single SSD, and can be upgraded to 4 terabytes total via a combination of two M2 slots, PCI Express 4 M2 slots. Uses laptop memory, so you could go to 64 gigs via SODIMMs, and those kind of specs, along with the H series processor and the laptop 4060 GPU, kind of bring you to gaming laptop, mid-range, budget territory? What would you define it
as? Yeah, I think despite the obvious desktop, design and form factor and all the other things like liquid cooling and stuff you don't normally get in a laptop, the specs and power level and the chosen components kind of add up roughly to, I guess, a lot of gaming laptops. That's about what you see. The price is even right for a 4060, maybe a little more expensive because of the liquid cooling and the higher end processor, but you see a lot of gaming laptops, $1,300, $1,400, $1,500, even $1,600 that are still running an RTX 4060. So you're in about the same ballpark. There's more room for cooling in this, probably. The liquid cooling thing should run, a little cooler. Obviously the lights and the metal build, it's nicely made. So the price makes sense, but yeah, I think power and sort of feature set wise, you're looking at roughly a gaming laptop higher end performance with a lot of extra connectivity and some, bells and whistles like the screen and other things that you won't get on a gaming laptop.
Right, just minus the screen and the keyboard, which obviously you'll be bringing to this game yourself. So there we have the Megamini Gaming G1 from Geekom and Tecno, a co-design between the two companies. We'll be getting it in a final unit for this in a couple of months and check it out fully. But for now, here's a preview of this unique gaming PC. Hope you enjoyed it. And I'm John Burek. This is Matt Buzzy. See you next time on One Cool Thing.